But Zai is looking to fight the toss directly up, and Zai wants to call on Big Dang Noob Tail, but he's kiting this perfectly, but he gets the spin, needs another great nightmare timing from Misery, and Envy has a toss, he's gonna get the first blood. Great start to this game for Cloud9, really well. Getting some good hits on this mid-tier 1 tower. Wisp even coming in with the tether heal as well as the overcharge onto Fata, who's just gonna tank up the tower, keep the siege creep alive, and Secret, unless you start rotating in heroes, this is going to be an early tier 1 tower, and a mid tier 1 tower at that. Deny comes in, S4, going to deny some much wanted gold from Fata. In, but the skewer into an RP, but nope, there's no RP. Bonesaver's not even level 6. Teaser going to now pop the ultimate. The toss is going to finish him off, though. Envy brings down the young prodigy, and Cloud9 going to lose their Magnus in the meantime. Fata looking to throw more raises, hits a few, but not enough damage to bring down the Venge or the X. Both. Just one raise away from dying. S4 comes back after dying, gets the orb into a waning rift, and Secret winning this juke fight battle so far, but Avalanche hits two, followed up by one right click. Has a toss in a couple of seconds here. Kuro now in all sorts of trouble. The Shadow Fiend gets thrown forward. There's no mana for a raise, but doesn't matter. C9 get another kill. Arteezy, meanwhile, getting the kill on the Wisp there with... relocate. Arteezy's being found. He's going to shapeshift, but it may not be able to get off. The Avalanche toss is there, and Arteezy gets slam dunked, and Puppy in trouble as well. Here comes S4, but the Dream Coil may save Puppy. Not going to get caught out just yet. It's S4, and Zed going to go down to the toss. No phase shift available, and he wants Puppy as well. The chase is on. Global Silence comes out, but that's not going to save the Ventral Dream. Triple kill for Eternal Envy. He wants more. It looks like C9 being pushed back here. Zai blinks in with a call. They want to bring down the Big Daddy No-Tail Wisp here, but Zai is just too squishy. He's going to be brought down if he's not careful. The toss is not there. One more right click. Fata gets the kill. Envy, meanwhile, gets himself his 11th kill. The Fiend's Grip going to get dealt with by the Summoned Wolves here. It's a 3-for-1 so far, and Fata kept alive by a fantastic RP. Secret going to lose their whole team at this rate. Arteezy looking to escape. Wisp has come. Beat us.
The adjustment that C9 made was very good this game with the last pick Shadow Fiend. Changed up a lot of their strategies, their laning phase as well. Like the statsman mentioned, this is the first time in 11 months, which is almost a year, that Fata has played Shadow Fiend. And what a game to actually pick Shadow Fiend for Fata after such a long time. And I think it was the main reason why Secret couldn't run their game plan, because the lanes were ruined. They couldn't lane as they wanted to.
They laned it so well. And this is the first game, I feel like, all tournament. Cloud9, they had a good start to day one where they definitely looked like one of the teams to beat. But after day one, they kind of just fell off. And people, like, when talking about Cloud9, were like, eh, they're good, but they're not going to be a top title contender. Mm. But you see a game like this, and you think this team can beat anyone. This team could go the distance.
I think Jackie is a very smart player. He, even at times, people could argue he makes a lot of mistakes at sometimes, and he makes very questionable plays. But I expect this sort of... stuff from him, like adapting and changing it at the last moment of the draft. The blink dagger was brilliant for the tiny. I mean, you see a lot of tinies go blink even with the Wisp, but not as early as he did after threats alone. So I think this game was a very good, well executed game from C9, and the draft was also the last pick, was the X factor that C9 had.
Well, Puppy, a drafter and captain, known for adapting, even going back to the Na'Vi days. Na'Vi were kind of the low bracket team that often have a bad start, shaky start to a tournament, and come back often on the back of Puppy's ability to adapt. So we're going to see if they can adapt. Before we go into Game 2, we're going to go back to the analyst panel and see what they have to say about Game 1.
Brutal. Just as expected.
Absolutely brutal. For us, our predictions,
yes,
as well as for Team Secret.
That was, I mean, I think the early blink dagger was huge.
I don't think we've seen, I cannot even recall seeing a blink dagger tiny in a competitive game with like a one position tiny in ages. It used to be, you'd see your tiny maybe.
Good bottle snipe, and that was, well, pretty straightforward one. Something that Secret maybe should have seen coming.
Bone 7 bottom in trouble. Gonna get slowed by the Grand Trio here. Poison touch as well. Oh,
Abaddon's
no.
On here. He's gone back to base. He didn't actually... I think he was out of HP, out of mana, and left Axe on his own. So first blood goes Secret's way. It's over the S4 Queen of Pain. Second game in a row, we're just seeing S4 get crushed mid. SF with almost double the net worth.
At this point, I think going for the orchids would be like a really tall task for him. Maybe changing the item selection that he wants to go for, going for Axe Scepter, easier to get, yeah. The easier lose their tier 1 tower in middle lane. Enigma's gonna, Zai's gonna move in towards the middle lane to help defend, and here comes the shapeshift from RTZ.
Well, we'll see them look to loop around here. Enigma with a black hole, they'll look to use the shapeshift with this black hole, but they back Radiant's off. They thought Cloud9 were gonna get greedy.
Oh.
Got the Aegis.
And here comes the Quark. Can he actually catch up?
Oh no, he hasn't got the Aegis. He's only got 100 HP. He's actually dying to the Wolves here. Envy may go down. He's trying to bottle up in between right clicks. The Necrobot could finish him off. Queen of Pain, oh, Blink in, Sonic Wave. Oh, it hits him. S4 gets the kill. Goes down. Slated now. Fart just got this Aegis still.
They
do need to get out. Black hole on just one. Immediately cancelled by Misery. Zai could not find the black hole he was looking for. The grave is there, but the Culling Blade from Bone 7, it's gonna go off. The Malifus isn't enough. Cloud9 have only lost Envy so far, and Secret have lost two. Make it three, and this is with buybacks. This is looking really... Well, single-handedly perhaps a bit of an exaggeration, but he's going to just keep on staying on the higher ground. Envy even going to come back into the fight here. S4 going to fight back as well, and C9 have to make a decision here. Do they fight? Do they run? Bata's being left alone in the base will pay the price.
Man, he got too cocky, though. That kill game... The main usage of the orchid is to just silence the axe when he blinks in and tries to get a call off.
Alright, well, Zai gonna get scouted out. Dire Observer Ward on the high ground. He has a blink forward. Bone 7,
oh,
please!
Bone 7.
Oh my.
Again, he gets caught out.
This
is looking...
Base! Cheesy now pops the ultimate! There's no glyph available! He dies in the fountain, but he's got Aegis! He can't even buy back and TP home! They're just gonna get the throne up of this! Holy shit! Cloud9 have lost game 2! I can't believe it! What? And that's with some terrible late game performances in previous matches where they lost a 30k gold lead. This, to me, takes the cake.
This is even worse than the game that they lost
against Big God.
With the Lycan pick against the Medusa. This is even a bigger... I wouldn't say they were in a very commanding position that they actually threw the game very hard.
It's the way they lost.
It was just the way they lost. It was very, very not disciplined. They were... They just played so cocky. You could tell from the middle fight, Feita was like, even though they were not able to kill him, but he was just like standing up front. The way he played the situation was very, they were very cocky, and I just felt that sometimes they just need to, you just need to back off after forcing buybacks, and that after that fight, they gave away so much gold and experience towards the Seeker side. They immediately smoke after defending their base. They got another pick off on Bone 7, another kill on, they got two kills, I can't remember on who. They took a tower, they almost won the Roshan fight, even though in the end Juggernaut bought out and still secured C9 the Rosh, but the Boots of Travel on Lycan, not having any TPs,
and just the axe, like he's the one who took the Aegis, like that was a
really
catastrophe. He also at the end, he's like, he went to suicide to fountain to buy back and of Cloud9.
Yeah, that was
Fata, meanwhile at bottom lane, gonna go down, or will he? He's trying to tango through, buys a TP scroll before he dies, and well, that's a second TP scroll. He's also got one back at base, and S4 will get the last hit on your axe. First blood though, claimed by Cloud9. We'll be able to scurry away to freedom. Bone7 has another Omni Slash at top lane meanwhile, and possibly looking to bring down S4 if he can. Misery has a Fissure available, and if he can get S4 away from the creeper, this could be a kill. Blade Fury gonna be used to start things off. S4 wants his kill, but the Fissure is there, and
a really good anti-fissure for Bone7 there.
Except needs to be careful, that healing ward is going to be very precious here as Puppy. I think realizing this mid tier 1 tower cannot be defended. Kuro not having the best game here. First the solo kill, or two solo kills going Bone 7's way, both on Kuro. The second, that one there a bit more... But I guess they just... Maybe they didn't click him and see it in time, because S4 could have just blinked back to safety.
But middle lane, they're gonna go in on RPG. Couldn't call it, Omni Slash.
Pops the mech, he's good for the Requiem of Souls, this huge damage, he gets a double kill with the help of Zai! It's actually Zai getting both those
damage because Shadowfin had mech and even he still had Aegis.
Even if Zai wasn't there, that didn't seem like the right play to make. Mid lane, Envy possibly in some trouble, here comes your Brood from behind, he gets the kill with the help of Arteezy and Misery now in trouble. Echo Slam used defensively, but he's still gonna die! They lose three! Arteezy with a haste room, Misery along the side here, but Misery may walk into a nice Echo Slam, only catches Arteezy, the Chain Stun is there, Dust used as well, Arteezy swapped back to safety, Bata gets the call though, down goes Artur, Mr. Babev, he will be seeing a trade here as Jug and Omnet go down on the Radiant side, Zai still getting back to safety, short, and here comes Misery with a counter, Echo Slam looking for the kills, Bata goes for the call, catches Artur, Guardian Angels while Bone7 now flanking from behind, doesn't have an Omni Slash now, Arteezy gets off the Requiem, blows up your axe, Misery now gets cast, it's bouncing between two, Misery may have a repel, but Puppy with the big Witch Doctor right clicks, gets that kill, Bone7's being tracked now by the amp damage, Witch Doctor, Death Ward gonna finish him up, 4 dead, Secret find, the team physical damage, Bata getting focused down, he has got the GA to back him up, Misery, Blink, Echo Slam, but he gets stunned, focused down, buyback coming out from your side, but he's gonna make this hold, Urshaker gonna fight back as well, Cloud9, this is their last leg, they're fighting for tournament life here, they lose Bata as well on the axe, 4 buybacks coming out here.
Rather sloppy one, didn't expect a game like this from Secret, they're usually very very disciplined, everything was very methodical in the group stages and up to the playoffs, and this game,
it felt like one of their weakest games of the tournament.
Yeah, they definitely didn't feel like they were playing on top of their A game, but they still could have ended the game a lot earlier, but unfortunately they made a couple of mistakes, but at the end of the day, Team Secret are still going to be really happy. A win is a win. They managed to take out C9 and end their hopes of the in the tournament, so we're gonna see Secret progress to the next round.
Yeah, I mean, speaking about happy, there was some all chat coming out from Envy in one of those games. Puppy, I'm sure, is captain's gonna be feeling pretty good about himself after that win.
I'm not a fan of all chatting in an event like this.
Yeah, well, Puppy lays down the smackdown, and it's Secret, as said, advancing. They're gonna meet Big God in the next round of the lower bracket. Congratulations, Team Secret. We're gonna go back to the panel and see what they have to say as we round up day 3.
What a series. It appears that Secret is destined this tournament to have the most epic series of all. VG Gaming first, now Cloud9. They were this close to losing Game 2. Game 3, completely different story.
I mean, people are talking about giving Eternal Envy your energy, but Secret are just... They're giving up all their own emotional energy just to get through these games, and... I mean, look, going into tomorrow, they're exhausted.
That was it's pub game, by the way.
It's 2 a.m. in China, you know? I mean, what more is there to say?
Dagon, Ethereal Blade, Broodmother, that is
extremely good.
But it worked. It worked.
It's such a pub that everybody's going to start building this.
Yep, they already are.
They're going to start picking Brood now.
I don't know if you want to talk a lot about that build, if you want to go a little bit in detail about it. But the thing is, when you start taking control of the map with the Brood, you saw Cloud9 got so desperate, they started blocking their own jungle.